Hey guys, in this video I will be talking about pages in the UI Builder. A page is a fairly well understood concept in web applications. And in UI Builder, they really represent exactly what pages are. It's a section of your web application that contains a specific functionality. But something to keep in mind is that in UI Builder, whenever you build an application, whether it's mobile or web application, it is going to be SPA, single page application, which means that when you go from one page to another, from one section of your app to another, there is not going to be page reload in the browser or in the web app. It will show up instantly. Thus, it will function as one cohesive application. Creating pages in UI Builder is very simple. You just need to know that in this area where it says editing page and it displays the name that we're editing, when you move the mouse over, a little pop-up displays where part of it will say pages, and this is the area where it will list all the pages that exist in your application. To create a new page, simply click this new page button and type in a page. So here we could say contacts or contacts page if you'd like. Doesn't really matter, it's going to be completely up to you. In here you will also have a drop down that says create as, and there are several options: blank, fork, and template. When you select blank, it's going to be just completely blank page without any pre-built decorations. If you select template, then there are several templates to choose from. We're actually working on the change where you can see a preview of what the template looks like. So next time you visit UI Builder, you may already see the updated new page pop-up, but the functionality is going to be exactly the same. And we try to name them in a way where you can sort of predict what that template will look like. So landing page is the one that has this title bar at the top and kind of nice borders and some nice shading. So here we will create context page as template for landing page. Click create, and now the contacts is created. How do you rename? Well, once again, move the mouse over this area. The current page has this kind of a shading that indicates that this is the current page, and you get the little gear icon. If you click on that icon, then you can rename this page, and then, for instance, you can say My Contacts. Click Update, then the page is renamed. To delete a page, once again, move the mouse over, click the gear icon, and then click the Delete the Page button, confirm, and then the page is deleted. And here it's selected 404, but we'll be talking about 404 in a different video. Let me show you how to create replicas of the page. So let's say if you're working on the page and you added some logic, so let me create a page called test. And in here I will drag a panel and change the title to something like Cool Panel. And then we could add business logic here, just anything you want. You could have a super complex page. And let's say you just want to make a copy to try out some things without changing anything in the original page. To create a copy of this page, so we have test. Let's create a copy of this test. Click New Page, and we will call it Test Copy. Under Create As, there's going to be an option called Fork. And then when you select Fork, it will create a copy. So we select Create Copy of Test. Click Create. So now we have a page called Test Copy, and as you can see, it has the same panel and looks exactly the same, has exactly the same functionality if there were any. So in here we covered creation of new pages, updating, changing the name, deleting pages, and creating copies. Now there is one more thing that I wanted to show you, and that is the main page. So the main page is the one that is loaded by default when the application is visited. Whichever page has designation as the main page, you will see this little icon that looks like house. And if you want to change the designation, just select the gear icon for any page. So for instance, the state test copy, if you want to make it the page, click the gear icon, select the checkbox, is main page, click update. So now test copy becomes the main page. That covers everything that I wanted to share with you in this video. Thank you for watching, and as always, happy codeless coding.